Okay, so last week I was writing a scores and trying not to let Ronnie look at me when I was putting it in, so I'm like halfway through, sort of.
Yeah. I haven't gotten anywhere with it. I got the email. Oh!
Hey, what's
up? Oh, hey, how's it going? Yeah, oh, you're here from chapel choir, that's right.
He's awesome.
Guys.
Guess what?
Dude, we're late.
New person, and we're always late.
Hey, nice to meet you.
Hi.
Hey. When I first got to Duke, I didn't really know what to do. I didn't really have any friends, didn't really know what I wanted to do with my life, but I did know that I wanted to sing. And so I joined chapel choir, and I met my best friends at Duke in chapel choir, and it has been the most rewarding experience that I could possibly imagine having here.
I never really had an opportunity growing up to be in any sort of musical group like this. And so when I had gotten here at Duke, I had heard about the chapel choir through one of my new friends and paid a visit. Came to an open rehearsal, and I knew that this is exactly what I've been looking for, to sing in a group that's this large with this many people who know what they're doing is incredibly awesome. And for me, it was definitely the chance of a lifetime.
I'm a math major, so I'm not really an art person, and I don't really sing. Like, my singing experience has been in a bathroom, so that was it.
I went to the first open rehearsal there. I just knew it was the place to be. I mean, I loved that there were students there and there were adults there, and you got to meet so many new people, and I got to make great friends, and it was a great experience. And so I joined, and I can't seem to leave.
The first time I ever sang here, I remember, you know, I'd been to the practices, we rehearsed in the chancel, but we don't really get the full effect until the first Sunday. And one of my choir buddies leaned over to me and said, "Is this, you know, your first Sunday?" And I said, "Well, yeah, this is my very first." He said, "Well, definitely enjoy it because you only get it once." And he was so right.
And I came, and then I was so intimidated the first time. Like, it was scary. First time in this huge church, which I've never been to before. I've never been to a church service. And the first couple of weeks, I was just lost. Like, okay, I'm done. I'm falling asleep in the sermon. Ronnie's gonna kill me. But then, I guess I met people. Sunday service, morning, food, good. And they were so nice. They make jokes. You feel like you're home.
You know, one of the things that I encounter every year is that people come and they hear the choir, and the choir is fantastic, and especially in the chapel acoustic, and they think, I'm not good enough to be in that choir. It's not true. We're made up of a bunch of singers, some of whom have a lot of talent, and some of whom have only a modest amount of talent. Let's face it. You know? But you put all that together in this magical transformation that's choral singing. That's what we love about it, you know? It becomes greater than any one of us by a long shot. So nobody should be intimidated in thinking that they're not good enough for it.
I have to admit, the trip to Spain by far is incredible. So, I mean, to sing at a place like that is pretty phenomenal, but to go on tour with these people is another experience entirely.
What'd you guys do?
We climbed that statue, you remember that?
Oh, we climbed the statue
in Barcelona.
Right, because they have that custom, right, where you get the grapes and you have to eat how many grapes at midnight?
12
for each.
And so we got like some champagne or wine and some grapes, yeah. And we climbed. They have this Christopher Columbus statue, mm-hmm. And I remember Aiden like,
"Oh my God, no!"
Oh, have been there. Well, now you could be there if you date.
Walker wasn't, because he was in China.
I wasn't in Spain, but I went to China, and we had plenty of fun in China.
You sang on the Great Wall.
We did. It was January of 1997. And we basically got to stand there and sing the Chinese national anthem.
I was 10.
I was 12. Right.
Well, the great thing about the trip is you get to know everybody really well. And we spend 4 hours, well, sometime. We spend 4 hours a week together, but most of that's really working time. You're going on a trip, you've got just hours of time. There are not many other pressures, and it's really fun. And, you know, you always have one thing that you share in common, and that's the love of great choral music. But you also have this shared humanity, these great people.
We're going to Carnegie Hall this summer. Are you going to Carnegie Hall?
I went last year.
I want to go this year.
But we're going to see you.
We
are going to see you.
Where did you see in, what, 2 weeks?
Yes.
Less than 2 weeks.
Yeah, less than 2 weeks.
Spend the whole weekend
exciting.
Together.
Yeah.
Bonding.
The music like not only is good, but we get to sing a song composed by the organist, by David Arcus, who is the man.
Amazing.
David is an incredibly talented musician and organist and improviser, and he's been here for 20 years like I have, and so we have this incredible musical symbiosis which just helps all of us flow efficiently and smoothly and be at a high level musically.
And for those of you who don't know what symbiosis means, they feed on each other, kind of like this.
Are there?
Don't fall asleep.
Don't fall asleep. That was a no-brainer.
Seriously,
especially when your snoring is drowning out the service.
Well,
I can't hear what's
open.
Going on over there.
Like this.
There's definitely a polished ass.
Why would you know about this?
I saw this fly coming down and suddenly this big wind sucked it in. She gagged on it. That gave me my first clue there ought to be a rule.
Oh no.
Audition is not
it's
scary.
It's so not scary.
Yeah, if you can spell your name and walk a straight line, pass the audition.
I think you've had to practice that already.
No, you need to.
But it's definitely worth it.
It's a friendly audition. Yeah.
Well, it is a friendly audition. I mean, you need to show some ability to sing.
And I think it's not just a community of singers, it's also a community of people who have similar goals. Some of us are very religious, so it's a community of believers. Others come for the singing itself, and I think they get amazing amounts out of the opportunity to sing really solid choral repertoire on a weekly basis.
When I was in the hospital earlier this summer, and I heard the chapel choir come on, I was watching it on TV, I couldn't help but imagine the people that were in it, and it did an amazing thing in my head. I just started imagining these faces and thinking, I really, really like these people, you know? I miss them, genuinely. Not for the music. I do.
It keeps me sane, it keeps me happy. It's a wonderful way of expressing feelings and emotions and connecting with people on a totally different level, and I just wouldn't give that up for anything in the world.
You'll think that you're a student and you've got so many obligations, but life doesn't get any easier, I can tell you, as I'm approaching 30. I don't have the time either in medical school, but I'm doing it, so you can do it too.
I'm from Malaysia, and I remember, like, it's one of those big transition things when you come from a foreign country and you come to America, and things are different, hands down. People have different cultures, they expect things differently from you. And so I guess it's always scary walking into that. Like, I don't really know what I'm doing, especially in a place like as holy as a chapel. But as long as you have family like chapel choir, you can screw up as much as you want to and they will still love you. Your parents might not even love you that much. Well, I lie. Don't tell them that, please. I love chapel choir.